simulations. Earlier we had seen, we were using functions like rand and rand between. These are volatile functions which we were using earlier. Now using volatile functions, there are some things which we can simulate in Excel. Okay, the random functions, the random nature of the functions which we have talked earlier also. Okay, so we know that rand is nothing but, it gives a number between 0 and 1. Rand is nothing but a uniform 0,1 distribution. So it gives any number from a uniform 0,1 distribution range. So if in exam or in CP2 or maybe anywhere, if we are told, let's simulate numbers from a uniform 0,1 distribution. See, I tell you simulate 100 numbers from a uniform 0,1 distribution. So your simulation count, which is 100 here, I'll fill this 100. How do I use fill? 1. I go to fill series and columns and then I do the stop value 100. Okay. And then my simulation values is equal to rand of just nothing. I don't have to give any arguments. Okay. And this fills. And we know this is a volatile function. So this will keep on changing when we work in Excel. Okay. We do not require to do a pay special value until and unless we are asked to do so. Okay. Please don't use pay special until and unless asked to do so. Keep your values random in nature. So this is from a uniform 0,1. But now if I want uniform 5,10, I want values from uniform 5,10 distribution. How do I do? If I want values, no, I don't use rand between for uniform 5,10. This is a very wrong concept. Rand is uniform 0,1, but rand between is not uniform A,B. To simulate numbers from 5,10. So this formula is very important. Very important, will be required almost everywhere wherever we need to do simulations from uniform A,B. The formula is rand into, not writing equals to here, rand into B minus A whole plus A. Okay, so this is the formula which we use for simulation. This is very important. Rand into B minus A plus A. Now you must be wondering, how did this come up? So simulations are nothing but Monte Carlo simulations which we are doing over here. So what we do, we basically equate the CDF of the distribution with uniform 0,1. So if you see the CDF of uniform distribution, the CDF is nothing but X minus A divided by B minus A. The CDF, if in the tables you see, it's X minus A divided by B minus A. Okay. So if I have to equate it for X, I will equate it with uniform 0,1. Okay, this will give me an error. Sorry, instead of just uniform 0,1. Now this is the right hand side, this is the left hand side. I have to equate it for X. And if you see that X then will become U01 into B minus A and whole plus A. Okay, this is what X becomes. And X is the number which we want to simulate. So here we can get uniform 5,10 distribution from rand between, rand, which is uniform 0,1, into B minus A, which is 10 minus 5, and whole plus 5. So this gives me distribution from uniform 5,10. If you see, all values will be between 5 and 10. Okay, clear? Next is using simulating values for other distributions except uniform distribution. Say I want to simulate values for normal distribution. Normal, for where mean is 5 and say the variance is 64. Normal 5,64. Mean is 5, variance is 64. So simulation values, let's increase this. For normal 5,64 is, we use the function norm dot inverse. returns the inverse of a normal cumulative distribution for the specified mean and standard deviation. For any distribution, for simulating any distribution values in Excel, we'll always use the INV function beside the distribution's name. So norm.inv, probability is nothing but again RAND over here. Any simulations we do, we always use uniform 0,1, which is basically this part, what we are doing. We equate the CDF with a uniform 0,1 with a given set of parameters, and then it will give me a values between those range for the distribution. Okay, so norm.inverse RAND, mean has been given to us as 5, and I told you all earlier in the statistics class also that distributions take standard deviation and not the variance, so we have to do a SQRT of 64. Okay, so this will give me simulation values. Okay, for a normal distribution. Similarly, if we go for gamma distribution, gamma distribution, say I am assuming alpha and lambda to be 5 and 64 only itself. Now gamma dot inverse. Now probability is RAND, we know. Alpha is I am assuming to be 5, and beta. Now what is beta? Beta is not lambda in our Excel. Beta is 1 by lambda in Excel. So I have to give 1 by 64. Okay. So then it will give me simulation values. Clear? Similarly, for exponential also I can show you all. Exponential distribution simulation values. So this is equal to exp. No, so Excel doesn't offer exponential inverse. Okay, it only offers exponential distribution. Then we cannot do this in Excel. Okay, if you want, you can do it equating your own CDF. Equating your own CDF, like that is, if I do the inverse of the CDF, it comes up to 1 by lambda, which is, I am assuming lambda to be 5, 1 by lambda. Into log of u is nothing but again random zero comma one with a negative sign in between in the front. Okay, so this will give me value. So for distributions who do not have INV functions, you can equate it in your copy, the CDFs, and then you can just put in the formula over here. Okay, so for exponential distribution, I'll just write the x, which you can note down. It is equal to minus 1 by lambda into log of uniform 0,1. Okay, not writing it with an equal to sign, because you can note it down. Clear? So this was basic simulations. This is very, very important, because for any simulations which we need to do using uniform distribution, uniform 0,1 distribution, we need to use the RAND function, and these will keep on changing the values in the Excel sheet. Plus, please do not use pay special in the calculations. Okay,